The concert this evening is dedicated to Father David Kessinger, who was affectionately known around here, around the monastery, as Father David K, because we have another Father David, and he was just Father David, but the other one was Father David K. And so he was a very staunch supporter of the arts and was often in here. I have to say, being the organist, I'm the organist here, he would recognize pieces that I played a lot of times. He would talk to me afterwards about a piece I played because he was friends with Father Kenneth Geyer, who was the former organist here, you know, one of the monks. So it was really kind of nice to say, oh, why weren't you playing? And he would even say the name of the piece because he knew who the composers were and everything. So in the back, where the sign-up book is, there's a couple pictures of Father David K, I think taken back in the 80s when he was in Vienna, and he sought out a lot of the composers. And that is there's two pictures of him back there with the memorial to Schubert. So I thought that was good. And I have those pictures because he gave me copies of those pictures when I did the Schubert program. He said, well, these are some programs, some places that I've been, and so he wanted to share them with me. So we dedicate our program tonight to Father David K, and I hope you will enjoy looking at the two pictures that are back there that I have open. So I believe from that, we are ready to go, and I believe they're going to switch the first two pieces on the program. Since we dedicated the program to Father David K, they decided that they would start with the Schubert, so they'll switch the first piece, I think, in the second piece. And other than that, it'll follow as it is, just there. So I thank you so much for coming, and we can see they're all here, and they're all ready to go, so we will welcome them, and I hope to see you at the next concert, and make sure you're on our mailing list, and just social distance with people. If you want to talk, maybe you can stand 10 or 15 feet taller if you want to talk. Or send the Bechtler Ensemble a nice email. Thank them for coming. But your applause is what they'll be glad to hear tonight. Thank you very much.
Mention a chord is made up of three notes. notes or more. And as you can see, we are three players. And so the chord is what creates a beautiful harmony. For example, 1, 3, 5. Each of those notes are extremely important to create this beautiful harmony. So each note that the three of us are going to play is going to, especially for Schubert, who was such a great melody writer, will really enrich the whole harmony. So here's Schubert, string trio E-flat. Thank you. is also a linguist, a music critic, a music educator, a philosopher, and an ethnomusicologist. So a man of many, many talents. And he was a leading ethnomusicologist along with Bartok. He went into the fields in the summers from 1905 to 1915 in Hungary and collected over 1,000 of these folk songs. And he had them recorded on these cylinders, somewhat like a phonographic cylinder. And thanks to him and Bartok, we now have this music, and many composers are inspired by this folk music, as was Kodaly and Bartok. Here's a quote from Bartok about Kodaly. His music as a profession is a profession of faith in the spirit of Hungary. It is rooted in the soil of the Hungarian folk music. I also want to mention that his educational system, the Kodaly method, was highly successful. Used the movable dough, rhythm symbols, syllables, hand signs, pictures, and of course folk songs. Here's Zoltan Kodaly's Intermezzo.
Thank you.
by the name of Jean Cras, C-R-A-S, French, 20th century also. This piece we're about to play for you is just one movement. It was written in 1928. The interesting thing about Jean Cras is that he was actually a fully commissioned officer in the French Navy. So he wrote music kind of on the side, and he was inspired by the sea, church, and by his native Britain as well. So our violinist Lenora Leggett, when she found this piece on YouTube, and she shared it with us, and we all said, oh, this is just wonderful music, and it should be played. And there's so many incredible composers out there that actually not too many people have heard of, so we will make sure that at least on each program we have one of those composers that are not so well known. So here is Jean Cras, his first movement of the string trio. And when it starts, I could imagine having a steamship starting to go and hearing that engine. So you'll hear that in the cello. first name, so he became Jean Sibelius. He is known for his famous Finlandia, which is pretty much Finland's unofficial national anthem. And he really forged the Finnish identity, the national Finnish identity, through his music. This particular piece we'll be playing for you was from his more mature chamber music works. It was also never finished, and it's only one completed movement called It's a Lento. So, Jean Sibelius grew up in a musical family. His siblings played instrument, his mother played the piano and the harmonium. So they had a lovely musical upbringing, and he also became, as an adult, a national hero for his country. I thought it was a bit funny when he talked about music critics, and he said, "Pay no attention to what the critics say. No statue has ever been put up for a critic." Of course, at the same time, we know that those musicians, composers that have helped other composers become famous is that they write about their works, but most likely in a positive light. So here is Jean Sibelius' trio called For Lento. another Hungarian composer by the name of Verno Dohnanyi. It's a pretty well-known piece, at least those that are music lovers. It's the Serenade in C major. It was written in 1902, and Dohnanyi was only 25 years old. It really, you can hear the true Hungarian flavor, and less of that late romantic influence that was there at the time. He really broke free of that and wanted to have his own voice and his own stamp on his music. The Serenade is written in 5 movements, but we're only going to play 3 of those. The first one is a march, the second one is a romanza, and then we're going to skip to the 4th one, which is Tema con variazioni. As far as his chamber works, he really only wrote 9, and Brahms was instrumental in helping to get his music known. Something else that I wanted to note is that during World War II, he protected and saved many Jewish musicians' lives from the Holocaust. Unfortunately, there was a smear campaign against him, and people made it seem like it was the opposite, but he was really one of those forgotten heroes of the Holocaust resistance. Here is Dohnanyi, Erno Dohnanyi's Serenade in C major. Thank you.